And lastly, for conspicuous bravery in the line of duty, Detective Constable Isabel de Pauli. I see you're transferring to Liverpool.
Yes, sir.
Well, good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Awful place.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you could have knocked.
Where is he?
I haven't seen him.
I told you before about this. Sometimes you just don't listen to me.
I'm Detective Constable Callahan from the Plainclothes Department of Merseyside CID, based at Bridewell, Liverpool 1.
Constable Callahan, I'd like to go back over some of your evidence. In particular, the events of last May the 7th. Is it the case that you had obtained a warrant to search number 11 Aintree Drive?
Yes.
The premises occupied at the time by my client, Mr. Sullivan?
Yeah.
And that you and other members of the plainclothes squad then went to the premises and instituted a search?
We found half a kilo of cocaine.
If you could just answer the questions, please.
And several illegally held firearms.
Your Honour.
Constable.
Had you ever been to number 11 Aintree Drive before, Constable?
No.
I see. Can you then explain to the court, Constable, why the house you proceeded to enter and search was in fact number 9 Aintree Drive? In point of fact, Constable Callahan, the house you raided, the house occupied by my client, Michael Sullivan, was number 9 Aintree Drive, and not number 11, as stated in your warrant.
You were saying that the warrant was wrong.
A natural mistake, Your Honour. In Liverpool, for reasons of superstition, houses are frequently not given the number 13. This displaces all the street numbers, and no doubt confused the officers. But since this does appear to be a case of unlawful search, there are certain matters of law which we would like to discuss with you in private.
Very well.
Defense have guessed there was an informant involved in the arrest. They want to put him on the stand.
They want to put him in the Mersey.
I mean, you did tell a judge there was a serious risk of intimidation.
Well, of course I have. But now the address is wrong, the judge thinks they have a case. So, either we reveal the identity of the informant, and submit him to cross-examination, or we drop the prosecution. No.
Callahan? You blew the warrant. You owe us.
Look, I didn't blow the warrant.
Oh, sir. You want to see a major gangland criminal like Mike Sullivan back on the streets just to save your poxy little informer the bother of testifying? Is that what you want?
Well, that's it then.
Nine lives, me, Callahan.
Yeah.
All of them crap.
DC is about to call in here to see D.I. Howard Jones.
Yes, I'm Howard. Come in. Welcome to Bridewell, Isabel.
Paulie, can't stand Isabel. Thanks.
Hey, Paulie. Delighted to have you. City centre's bastards. Well, you probably realise that anyway. But we've got some scum here. And that's just the busies. We got gangs, drugs, clubs, insurance, brokers. But, you know, it's a challenge. And it's, well, it's fun, you know. I'm pairing you with Callie to start off, because he's our most experienced officer. And he's a good lad. Excuse me a minute. Jeff! Gotta go, Callie.
You cocked up the water, Frank. You got the wrong address on the warrant.
What? Oh, I can't
believe it. But they haven't threw it out. Don't tell them they threw it out.
What do you think they did?
Do you think they done, Frank? The wrong bloody number.
Well, you can talk. You were supposed to do it yourself.
How could you do that?
We have to move quickly.
I don't like to bang on about this, boy, but you're joining tightly knit, highly motivated team. Here's the squad.
What's going on?
Search warrant Frank did for Mikey Sullivan had the wrong address on.
No.
Mikey's got off and he knows for sure Callie's got an informant.
Oh, dear God.
We have to rush it.
I'm going to have to tell our boss. Canteen in 10 minutes.
Hi. Who are you?
Howard. You said you were going to put that new girl with Frank.
I did.
Oh, come on, Howard. She's useless.
So's Frank. At least she's got a degree.
No.
Psychology, and she's done 2 tours in Vice with the Met.
So what's she doing up here, then?
She requested the transfer.
And how come she gets a job here without doing time in uniform?
We're under strength. And we're crap.
She must be shagging someone.
Take her everywhere, show her everything, and look after her, please. Callie.
Are you complaining about having me as your partner?
No. Want to get a coffee or something?
He looks pretty upset.
Yeah, I heard you had a psychology degree.
Yeah.
So, you left the Met then?
That's right.
What brings you up our way?
I wanted to join a tightly knit, highly motivated team. Black. I want mine black.
So, you're from London, then?
Not really, yeah. All over.
All over what?
We moved around.
Oh, right, you moved around.
Yeah, we were abducted by aliens. Look, why don't we just start with a general briefing?
Look, I'm just trying to get acquainted, that's all.
Yeah, well, that's not what it feels like, getting acquainted.
I'm just making conversation. So, you got a boyfriend?
What?
You going out with someone, you know, a man.
What's that got to do with anything?
Just asking, you don't want to tell me, that's okay.
It's not that I don't want to tell you, I just want to know why you're asking.
All right, forget it. So what you should know is, juries here are bad. 52% of cases get off.
It might be less if you got the address right.
What?
I said it might be less if you got the address right.
Chief Inspector Hill would like to say a few words.
Right. This Sullivan business is a total bloody disaster. Press are going to have a field day with it. You'll probably make the nationals tomorrow. However, the damage is done. So I want no vendettas. Do you hear? You had your chance with Sullivan and you blew it. So now you just pull your socks up and you get on with your job. You're the laughing stock of the bloody division.
Well, he's right about that.
Don't worry.
We'll get Mikey back ourselves. He'll be locked up for 6 months, so sooner or later he's going to blow a fuse. And when he does, we'll be there. Where have you been?
Hiding. By the way, there's been a disturbance down the sub club. Just come in.
John Sullivan, part legitimate businessman, part major drug supplier. You've got pubs and clubs all over Merseyside, and this is the hub of his little empire. And that is his baby brother, Mikey, who slipped through our fingers at court this morning.
Morning, Mr. Sullivan. Not a spot of bother, I hear.
You know, I hate to sound critical, Howard.
But don't you think it's a bit small-minded coming down here like this?
We heard you had some trouble.
Yeah, I heard we had some luck. John Sullivan.
Detective Constable DePauli.
A southerner and a woman.
Yeah, there were mitigating circumstances.
I'll bet. Well, sad to say, the force up here is full of ill-mannered macho bigots who don't like outsiders much.
You okay?
Who are you talking to? Liam. It's all right, Mikey. Liam, go and get Carol a drink.
Una paloma blanca.
Must be nice to have him back.
He's got a lot on his mind, see. He's very upset about the person who informed on him. If I was him, I'd be looking out.
Is that a threat, Mr. Sullivan?
No. Come down for a drink sometime.
Mikey's not all there, is he?
Diagnosed schizophrenic. You better find your informant. Get him out of town, Callie.
Do you want some help?
Look, it's not your problem. Thanks.
Okay.
Howard? That bastard Tulis in the dingle. He got thrown out of his window this morning. And his telly.
Now that's nasty.
CID have passed it on to us.
Tulis is a low-level drug dealer. He's one of our regulars. Why don't you tag along with Frank for now?
Sure.
Do you want to lead?
Mr. Tulis, I'm DC DePauley. This is DC White. We're sorry to hear about what happened. We'd like to ask you a few questions. The police said they saw a man running away. Do you remember anything about him?
No. I haven't done all this.
So you've never seen him before?
No.
Okay. So someone you don't know breaks down your door and throws you and your possessions out of the window. Does this happen often in the dingle?
All the time.
Look, this is about a drug deal, right?
Look, I need my script. I'll be coming off in a few days.
Yeah, well, we'll see what we can do.
I've got my collarbone, you know. I've got a crack rib.
Listen. If you want your script while you're in here, you sad scouse wanker, you better give me something in return.
Oh, yeah, then what are you gonna do, eh? Arrest him? I suppose you're not.
Nice technique. Subtle.
What did he mean, we wouldn't make an arrest?
He's off his head.
But why was there a police issue battering ram at the scene?
Probably Nick. Did you fancy a drink? I'm starving.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
What do you want, you godless pig?
Well, I'm fine, thanks, Father.
What do you want?
Patrick. Where is he?
How should I know?
So he's still in Wales, yeah?
Well, why shouldn't he be?
Well, I don't know. It was this morning I was chasing him out of the dealers in the dingle. Maybe I'm jumping to conclusions here. So where is he?
How should I know?
Because you always know.
Well, I don't. And if I did, you're the last person I'd call.
You tell me you don't know where he is. On the holy book.
I don't know where he is.
Lying bastard. Hello, Patrick. You're doing really well, you know.
Just leave me alone, Mark, please.
Listen. Listen to me. Mikey got off this morning.
Well?
It's possible he knows who informed on him.
Jesus, Mark, what? He got off? He's out.
I know. So So the best thing is we get you back down to Wales to rehab. It's nice and far away. You'll be fine.
What are you talking about, Mark? He got off. Look, Mikey knows it's me, right? I'm never going to be fine anywhere.
You'll be fine.
No, it won't, right? You made me do this, Mark. You said it'd be all right. You said he'd go away.
No, you said he'd go away. I won't let anything happen to you. I told you before about leaving that key outside. Sometimes I think you just don't listen to me.
Shut up, Mark.
Look, I'll be back after work. You just stay here till then, okay?
I'll think about it.
Let him go.
He's an addict, Ian.
He's your brother, for God's sake.
And yours. You look out for him. And 10 Hail Marys for lying on the holy book.
All right, Callie, let's get your informant sorted.
Yeah, she'll be okay. Callie, by the way, about the wallet. I know, it's okay, forget it.
So what do you reckon now? The poorly.
Vicious.
Fit though, or what?
You reckon?
In a vicious sort of way.
What I want to know is, right, how come she gets our job straight from transfer?
Must have shagged someone.
Probably at him afterwards.
You bastards.
I mean, what's she doing here anyway?
Hey, what about that bloke from your interview development course? He was from the Met, wasn't he?
Yeah, so?
So? Give him a call. They might have some gossip on her down there.
Yeah. Said I'd give him the pox.
Oh, Polly, yeah, that's your place there.
Cheers.
So, did you give him the pox then?
Look, I'd like to invite everyone out for a drink tonight, if that's okay.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be nice, wouldn't it, everyone?
Yeah. That's great.
See you later.
Okay. Sorry, I'm busy.
I'm not around tonight. Next time.
Sure. Howard, is it okay if I follow up on something from this morning? It shouldn't take long.
Yeah.
Sure. Frank and Joe are in court. Callie, you got anything on this afternoon?
It's my nephew's birthday. I said I'd drop in.
Oh, sure. Well, you've got time, on to you, anyway.
It's all right. I'll be okay on my own. Hi. Remember me?
He's not back from the hospital yet.
No, it's you I came to see. What's your name?
Dominique.
Mind if I come in? So you were here when your man got thrown out, yeah?
I didn't see anything.
Oh? So someone smashes down the door and throws your boyfriend out the window and you don't notice anything? What were you doing? Talking to the butler in the West Wing?
What do you want?
Look, I know you know who it was. And if you don't tell me, I am personally going to make your life unbearable. Do you want to hear how I can do that?
Oh, you really want to know, do you? Well, it was a busy one of yours. It's a big deal. What are you going to do? Nothing, that's what. Shut the door on your way out. I forgot you can't.
Okay. Tell me what happened.
What do you care?
Just tell me.
I don't know. The busy comes in, right, and he's looking for this lad who's staying over. They have a row and the busy goes mad.
Why would a policeman run away from the police?
Oh, well, it's not exactly official, is it? None of it. I mean, he just comes in, puts Dave's stash in his pocket and then does him out the window. Dave's not the first. I mean, they're all added up here, on the take, you know. Probably don't.
Do you know his name?
Yeah. Cali. Like Scally. Cali. So are you going to arrest him now then?
Hey, Ma.
Hi,
good
Joey.
To see you. Thanks for the stuff.
It's all right. It'll probably be out of date before he's aware.
Yeah. Sweet business, that, isn't it?
It's a rip-off.
Hey, wake up, Trotsky. Your side lost, remember?
Give us the phone, please. Hiya. Spent a fortune on that little spoiled bastard.
Not that little.
Hey, when you lot have kids, he has got to kick the shite out of them.
Any problem, miss?
It's a crappy turnout. No Patrick, no Ian, no Therese. You'd think they could make an effort for their only nephew.
Ian's with Patrick.
He's not run away again, has he? I don't believe him. That kid.
We are not talking about him. He is banned.
Where's Kelvin?
And he better not turn up here.
Off suing a pig farm in Cheshire. We're getting married, Mark. Yeah, thought you'd be pleased.
I'm just surprised. You're not the type.
I'm pregnant. Yeah, I thought you'd be pleased.
I'm just surprised.
Would you give me away, Mark? Ian's going to do the service. Here's Therese. That's you off the hook.
Ian said you used our patch to try and put Mikey Sullivan away. How could you do that? How could you do it?
Don't you think we should talk about this somewhere else?
No, I don't. You selfish, selfish bastard.
Thanks. That's great. Really great.
Paulie, have you seen the Echo? Horrendous. Nice picture of Callie outside the court, though.
Look, Howard, if it's all the same to you, I'd like to change partners.
Why?
It's just not working out for me.
You've only been with him a day.
Yeah, I know.
Look, Callie's a sound lad. It's just that he doesn't show his emotions, that's all.
Well, so far I've seen rage and gloom.
Well, he's got this Mikey thing. He's let it get to him a bit. Give it a week.
Okay. Eulis, in the dingle. Small-time dealer assault case. Howard passed it on to me.
You tell anyone about this?
Not yet. So what's he, you're ripping off the dealers? Nice car.
Look, I'm not ripping off anyone.
No, so why were you there?
I was looking for someone.
I have to tell you, now is not a good time to start playing coy. Oh, wake up, Callahan. You broke into private property without a warrant. And you threw a member of the public out of a window. What do you want from me? Look, I don't expect you to trust me right off, and I never expect you to like me. If you can explain this, I'll look after you. And if you can't, I'll turn your arse in.
Look, it's personal, okay?
No, it's not okay. You're a police officer, for Christ's sake, and so am I.
I was looking for my brother. Thewlis just got in the way.
So what, so your brother's a junkie? So? Jesus, he's your informant, isn't he?
Can I go now?
No.
I'll have that key back, thanks. Hello?
She's with me.
I'm probably working.
I'm Ian, his brother. He has to want it, Mark. I said I wanted him to stay here, go back to rehab with you, if that was his choice. If it wasn't, well, that was up to him. Look, I know you meant well. In your brutal, uncommunicative way.
You better pray. Because if anything happens to him, it's down to you.
My conscience is clear. He does mean well.
Yeah, I'm sure he does. I'm going home. Take me now. Wake up, you bastard. We haven't done it for months.
Polly!
Oh, fuck.
The national bloody sales manager!
John, why didn't you tell me you'd invite the bastard to dinner?
I told you weeks ago!
It was my first day, Will. It wasn't exactly great bloody timing.
He tore my operation to pieces today. That's all I bloody need.
Yeah, let's talk about you for a change.
This will be all around the company tomorrow, you know that.
Good.
Anyway, who said we haven't done it for months? Look, I'm just taking him out for a curry.
Okay.
So you had a bad day too, huh?
My partner hates me. The squad's a farce. It was fine. But obviously I'm still really upset about your embarrassment with the national sales manager.
So why does your partner hate you?
It's a long story, I'll tell you later.
Look. 2 more years hard labour and then we're back to civilization. Don't wait up.
Howard.
What's up?
Callie's brother's been shot. They don't think he's going to make it.
Cali says.
Okay, let's do it.
Are you registered?
Hello and good evening. Just a quick word about the forthcoming attractions here at the Zoo Club.
Yeah!
That's a bit cute to slices, of course. No, only kidding. Now, all this summer, Tuesday night is drug rave night, so bring your own handcuffs. Oops, sorry about that. Wednesday night is council fire regulations night. Always a lot of fun, that one. And then we're back here every Thursday for unhappy.
All right, then. Hey! We've met, haven't we? Yeah, this morning, you remember, you're Mikey's girlfriend, aren't you?
So is that a crime?
What's your name?
Carol.
Carol. You're from Essex, aren't you?
Are you arresting me?
I used to live near Hornchurch.
Right then.
Now, no need to panic. No need to panic. Just leave in an orderly fashion and hey, don't forget your money. Now, on behalf of Merseyside Police, may I wish you all a safe journey home. Thank you and good night.
So your fire alarm's okay then?
Not too sure about your wiring, eh?
We're looking for Mikey, Mr. Sullivan, in connection with the shooting in the Dingle this evening.
What shooting?
Patrick James Callahan.
Mikey's not here.
Well, of course he's not, but you know where he is. And I want him down at our place first thing tomorrow morning. He comes to us, no one else.
It's not what it was, you know, this place.
Not much else to do here tonight. You lot get some sleep. I'm going to the hospital.
I'll come with you.
Rain.
Not much our end either. No witness, no gun, no forensic, no Mikey. If it was Mikey.
It was Mikey.
Well, you can bet his big brother's getting a really good alibi together for him. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm really sorry about your brother.
No, I'll leave him in a minute.
I don't get how Mikey found him.
When he got Lucy going by smack, yeah?
Yeah.
So he'd ring around his contacts. Like that guy, Thewlis.
I know.
I saw Thewlis with Mikey this afternoon. Sorry? Thewlis sold him out. Listen, don't do anything stupid. This is a big enough mess already.
Sorry about that. It's the wife. She doesn't like me being out late at night.
Listen.
What?
I've got an idea, but it's a long shot.
How long?
Get in, Carol.
I've got nothing to say.
Two questions, you answer them, and then you can go. Or we can all go down the nick. First question. How did you meet Mikey?
What do you want to know that for?
Curious.
Really? A club in Colwyn Bay.
Nice.
Look, it was a laugh, okay? He had money, seemed all right. Can I get out now?
Just one more. Does Mikey know you're doing it with his brother?
Oh, God.
Still, I don't suppose he'd mind. I mean, it must have been pretty tedious for you while he was locked up. Not that he'll find out, of course. Look, he shot that guy 5 times.
You want me to tell you Mikey did him? Well, yes, all right, he did him. You know it, so do I. But you want me to stand up in court and say it? Screw yourself.
Look, don't you want Mikey put away?
Look, I don't care what you do. I'm never giving no statement. I'm never going to court against Mikey or none of them.
You won't have to. All we need is the gun.
out of theatre. We got the bullets out and patched him up as best we can. We lost the right leg beneath the knee. He's not strong. It's with God now.
Rubbish. Do you want to lift home?
No, thanks.
Listen, the gun's turned up. It's Mikey's.
You found the gun?
Yeah, well, he's a kid. Anybody else would have got rid of an incriminating weapon like that, but it's his toy, you know. So all we need now is Mikey.
Thanks for coming.
I'm sorry about your Patrick. I know this is important. I want you to give me Mikey. They found a gun. It's got his prints on. Mikey needs help. They lock him up someplace nice on the Whittle and you and your mom can go and visit him every Sunday. He's bad for business, John, and you know it. Bad for everyone.
I remember all those long hot summer days out here. Your dad's tranny blaring away. Five aside, I was Kevin Keegan, you were John Sosiak.
I was Kevin Keegan.
Christ, they were boring.
Give him up, John. Or they'll take him down in some shitty street somewhere. Is that what you want?
You want me to give my brother up? It's asking a lot.
You give him to me. I'll make sure he's okay.
It's not enough.
It's all I've got.
No, it isn't. You and I, Mikey, there's a price. The question is, how are you gonna pay it?
Come on, Mikey, get up!
Looks like we got the address right this time,
Mikey.
Take it easy, take it easy. I'll give the place the once-over. Get some clothes on. Right, that, I think, is the result.
Why'd you do it, Mikey?
Come on, come on.
One time Dad and I John had a fight, right? And he was in the garage. I John had put his bike in there and my dad didn't see it and he smashed it up. He messed it up in his car. Because he only had one eye, right? And he couldn't see some things sometimes. And he smashed the bike. When he got out, he called out John down and he beat him. He beat him up real bad. And then a couple of years later, John beat him up. And that was at the fair.
Yeah. Better get you dressed.
Red sky at night. Shepherds be light.
Jumped.
Christ.
I just jumped. I swear to God.
My cat. Bastard, he's done us again. Couldn't look any worse.
He was mentally ill, sir.
You better hope the coroner agrees with you, Jones. You get your statements in before you go, independently. I want this done by the book, do you hear? A death in police custody is as serious as it gets.